yes, with a diploma, we'll celebrate this magnificent collection of intelligence, heart, and of course, courage, assembled on this stage. Once again, it's with great pride at South Eugene High School, Prince presents the commencement ceremony for the class of 2000. Good evening and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, moms and dads, stepmoms and stepdads, brothers and sisters, grandparents, dear friends and loved ones. My name is Jerry Henderson. I'm co-principal of South Eugene High School. And on behalf of Lynn George, my partner and co-principal, our assistant principals, Joe Alsop and Larry Soberman, the Board of Education, the Office of the Superintendent, and the entire staff of South Eugene High School, I want to extend a very special welcome to each and every one of you. It is my pleasure to introduce our guests on stage. 4J Assistant Superintendent for Instruction, Tom Henry. School Board Member, thank you. School Board Member, Phil Barnhart.
And teacher, Sydney Renicky and John Hawkins, who have been specifically selected by our seniors to read the names of tonight's graduates. At this time, I'd like to welcome the South Eugene staff members who are in the audience.
The staff backstage who worked to organize this ceremony. A very special recognition goes to our colleagues who will take their leave through retirement this year. Rose Anderson, Edie Anderson, Robin Manela, Nancy Rose, Kelly Schwab, and Wayne Thompson. Thank you for being here. Now, Lynn was concerned about distracting any attention away from tonight's ceremony, but it would be conspicuous not to say the following. I also want to extend my very personal gratitude and our collective congratulations to South's co-principal of the last 7 years, Lynn George, as she prepares to take a new position with the Portland Public Schools in the fall. Lynn, we wish you well. Your presence will be missed as you move on to this new and exciting challenge. Thank you, Lynn. A very special thank you goes to Brenda Down,
our office manager, and the entire office staff for their invaluable contribution in coordinating this event. We want to extend our heartfelt thanks to the wonderful folks at Rhythm and Blues for the beautiful flower arrangements you see on stage tonight. And by the way, they did the same for us at last year's commencement, and we mistakenly credited another flower shop. So how about a shout out to all of you?
And finally, but certainly not least, I would like to have us thank the incredibly talented South Eugene High School Orchestra and its director, Richard Long. Now let me say to you, the graduating seniors of the class of 2000, Lynn, Joe, Larry, and I wish to add our voices to the chorus of congratulations you have so richly earned.
We also wish to congratulate your family, friends, and teachers who have been there to support you, encourage you, and yes, occasionally, endure you.
Especially, let us congratulate your parents. It's certainly more than a biological fact that you would not be who you are without them. Members of the graduating class of 2000, I invite you to join with me in thanking and congratulating your parents, grandparents, and other parental figures in your lives. The young men and women seated before you represent levels of talent, achievement, and promise matched by few, if any, graduating classes anywhere.
In the classroom, in athletic competition, in the performing arts, in the fine arts, and in the arena of community service, the achievements of this class are nothing less than astounding.
rich in diverse styles, values, and aspirations. This is a group bound by close friendships and shared memories. It's an honor to share the stage with these young people, as it has been to share their years at South Eugene High School.
I know that you are just as proud to share this evening's ceremony. Prepare to be dazzled as several members of this year's graduating class speak and perform for you tonight. And to guide us through tonight's program, it is my special privilege at this time to introduce the president of South's graduating class of 2000, a member of National Honor Society, sports editor of the National Award-winning Axe newspaper, captain of the South swim team, and my friend, I give you Miss Meredith Williams.
Ceremony of the South Eugene Class of 2000. As the president of the class, it is my privilege tonight to tell you how very pleased we are that you could join us with us in celebrating the culmination of our high school education. There have been many highs and a few lows along the way, but each and every experience has made a significant contribution toward preparing us to accept the challenges of life beyond South. And on behalf of my classmates, I want to thank our teachers, parents, relatives, and friends for your support and wise counsel. All of us leave with fond memories and a great appreciation for the value added to our lives by our many learning experiences at South. But we know that we will not look on those years as the best years of our lives. For the best years of our lives are yet to come, and so we welcome tomorrow. For tomorrow, we will begin a new journey, full of challenges, surprises, and satisfaction. A journey in which we are sure to discover what really will be the best times of our lives.
Tonight's program includes speakers and performers who will help us all reflect on how far we have come since the fall of 1996. It is with great pleasure that I introduce our first speaker. She was editor-in-chief of the Axe, and a shining light in South's music department through her great accomplishments on the violin and involvement in choir. Next year, she will take her talents to Mount Holyoke University. Ladies and gentlemen, Senior Lily Wells.
So here we are, the class of 2000, all 400 of us. How did we all get here? Where are we going? Looking at each other's faces brings back a flood of memory. Actually, there are a lot of things that the huge number of us went through together.
Whether the trophy we held over our heads was for the state championship soccer tournament or the Mountain Dew Jazz Festival, whether we left the building at 1 in the morning on an Axe deadline or arrived at 6:30 in the morning for dance team practice, whether we educated sophomores about HIV or middle school girls about racism, we all had something in common. It didn't matter that we all belonged to different organizations and worked on different projects. We all came away with the value of our experiences, working with our peers towards some common goal. But these common goals seem to be forgotten all too often. As seniors of a school that highly values academic achievement, we were often encouraged to look back at our achievements in high school, all the things we could put down on paper. After I wrote a resume to apply for jobs and fill out college applications, I looked over the list of my activities and accomplishments. Rather than feeling proud, I felt deflated.
There seemed to be so much missing. The clubs and the competitions, the organizations and positions held. Was this it? Was this high school? No, I thought. This isn't high school. These awards and titles and test scores aren't what have meant the most to me in the past 4 years. Those things are important, and we should have a chance to be recognized for our hard work. But it's equally important to remember and recognize the other things we've created in the past 4 years.
The strength of our friendships and the strength of our character. The support we received from those we cared about during times of adversity helped us to grow and change and become stronger. That's what's real. That's what's true. And those connections are what we'll take with us when we leave South. The diversity of our high school experiences is matched by the variety of our plans for the future. We're starting new jobs, joining the Army, going on exchanges abroad, doing internships, and attending colleges, technical and vocational schools, conservatories of music, and institutes of design. And where will we go next? At our 10th reunion, I might meet someone who's teaching physics at the U of O, negotiating a trade agreement with Cuba, playing jazz at nightclubs in San Francisco, publishing her first collection of poetry, coaching his daughter's first grade basketball team, lobbying for funding for education in Washington, D.C. The possibilities seem endless.
But it's not that simple. We have to take the first step. Whatever we choose to do next, we've made it this far, and that's something to be proud of. I'm honored to be part of such an amazing group of people. But after we give ourselves well-deserved pats on the back, after the ceremonies and the celebrations, after the parties and the congratulations, it's not over. We can't stop here.
It's up to us to go out and make positive change in whatever way we choose. Anatole France once said, "To accomplish great things, we must not only act, but also dream. Not only plan, but also believe. We should not only take action, but think about our actions. Why what we're doing is important to us, and how it will benefit our communities." Václav Havel, the president of the Czech Republic, once spoke about the concept of transcendence, going beyond what we know, surpassing what we previously thought were the limits of possibility. He said, "We should think of transcendence as a deeply and joyously experienced need to be in harmony, even with what we ourselves are not, what we do not understand, what seems distant from us in time and space, but with which we are nevertheless mysteriously linked because, together with us, all this constitutes a single world."
We have to go out and seek our place in that world and work to connect with the things that seem strange and distant, however hard that may be. Our senior class motto is to live the life we love and love the life we live. But we should also believe in the life we live.
Yeah, it sounds serious. Yeah, it sounds tough. And it is. But as different as all of us are, there's one thing we've surely gained from each other in the past 4 years. Courage. So have the courage to take that first step. We owe it to each other. Thank you.
Thank you, Lily. Our written program details students' accomplishments, and in the center you will notice that descriptors of some honors and awards are printed. At this time, we'd like to honor groups of students with outstanding achievements. The first group is the Oregon Scholars. These are students who are in the top 5% academically in the state. We have 42 Oregon Scholars. Will the Oregon Scholars please stand? Students, please stand. Thank you. The State Honors Diploma candidates all have grade point averages of 3.5 or higher. We have 56 State Honors Diploma recipients this year, and the District 4J Honors Diploma candidates are recognized by having earned a 3.5 GPA and having done 120 hours of community service. We have 70 students receiving those honors. Will the State Honors and the 4J Honors Diploma candidates please stand? Who are recognized for their participation in National Honor Society, which requires an accumulative GPA of 3.6 and their completion of 50 community service hours per year. National Honor Society, would you please stand? Eugene is proud to have 22 students graduating from the French Immersion Program. These students have studied French for 12 years and are fluent. They are part of the International High School, and the International Baccalaureate Diploma will be awarded to 28 students. These students each tested in 6 subjects, and their exams are graded on a worldwide standard. Will the IB candidates and French Immersion students please stand? Once again, to all these outstanding students for their accomplishments and their personal commitment to excellence.
At this time, I'd like to introduce our first senior musical performance, Carol Hawk, with the accompaniment of Sarah DeMoss and Matt Elvison. They will perform their arrangement of the piece entitled Reach.
She was my walking partner to Roosevelt for 3 years.
Her gentleness, intellect, commitment, and talent have always made her stand out in a crowd. She has been singing in the South Park for 4 years, participating in drama for 3, and still managed to fit in 7 advanced placement tests. She plans on staying English at the University of Washington next year. I am happy to present my old friend, Jenna Huntsberger, with her speech entitled Magic.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you to South Eugene High School's annual magic show. Sometime within the next hour, you're going to see a magic act of David Copperfield proportions. Before your very eyes, over 400 high school teenagers will transform into fully formed and fully functioning adults.
Surely, we've infiltrated the adult world. We've applied to colleges, we've gotten jobs or internships. Some of us have filled out a questionnaire about who we want to live with next year, and others have searched for apartments through the classified ads or over the internet.
Whether we wanted to or not, we've had to make decisions about the upcoming year, and all of us have some idea about which direction our life is pointed in, even if it's only for the next few months. And yet, in spite of this dabbling in the adult world, I confess, I don't feel any older. If anything, I feel younger. Every time I fill out an application or a form that pertains to my future, it's like I'm playing this elaborate game of make-believe. But this time, I'm not a princess or a My Little Pony or a ballerina. I'm a college student, willing to write papers, listen to lectures, and live in a dorm. And my playmate isn't a friend from down the street. It's a huge institution who's very serious about the game.
I keep on thinking that at some point, I'm going to have to get out of my mother's clothes and admit that this person who's going to college and signing up for an orientation day isn't me. She isn't the girl who still brings her lunch to school every day and sneaks out of class to buy gum.
Sure. I can play it being older, but if I'm supposed to be actually changing into an adult, wouldn't I feel different by now? I haven't seen the beginning of any drastic metamorphoses in my classmates either. These people up here on the stage are still the people who populate South's purple and white halls. They are still the people who hang out in the science wing and complain about the smell in the cafeteria. Either we transform tonight, or we go out into the world the same people we are now. A class of smart, talented individuals, to be sure. But adults, are we ready to fix the problems in the Middle East? Are we ready to start working towards those Rhodes Scholarships and Nobel Prizes? Are we ready to live up to the media's proclamations and build a bridge to the next millennium? I've been waiting to feel ready for this entire year. And I'm beginning to believe that it will never happen. I always thought that there would be a sign. Neon lights spelling out, "Move on," would flash over my head.
But during these final weeks, all the times I've shouted, "I can't stand this anymore," have been tempered with nostalgia. I can't help realizing how much I'm going to miss my teachers, my family, and my friends next year. And as I stand here tonight, and there's still no sign of magic wands or black top hats with rabbits in them, my hope for the quick fix approach to the future has almost run out.
And if confidence, poise, and knowledge will not be gained with the magic act or the few hours of this ceremony, then they will have to be gained the old-fashioned way, with hard work, additional life experience, And maybe that's what I'm most afraid of, that life is going to be just like high school. Sure, the classrooms will get bigger, or in some cases will disappear entirely, but I'm still going to have to muddle through the tough times, enjoy the good things that happen, and try not to be run down by the bad. As much as this epic is glamorized by the media, and as easy as it may seem 10 years from now, I don't think that any one of us has sailed through South without any problems. I doubt anyone on the stage is looking back on the past 4 years of his or her life and thinking, he's a king. I could do that again, any day.
Growing up is difficult. And guess what? We still have some growing up to do yet. So we're adults now, even though we're still the same people we were yesterday. Whether we're ready or not, our lives are going to change. But while I'm scared to be going to college, and while I don't want to have to sort through the tangle of registering for classes, making friends, and building an entirely new life for myself,
I feel better going out to the world than I would if I hadn't gone to high school. As silly and as troubling as my life at South Eugene has been, it's not something I want to forget. I know that these 4 years of muddling through will help me muddle through the next 4 years. The best I can do is take what high school has given me, which are friendships, knowledge, and experience, and try to use it to help me later on. So, graduating class of 2000, when we wake up tomorrow morning transformed without having changed, let's remember that we've had our 4 years, and now, what are we going to do with them? Thank you.
The next performance is quite a treat. It features seniors Sebastian Bolden, Raina Levert, Saeed Ansari, and
their original composition entitled, We're the Class 2000.
You might know when I'm showing you graduation. and we just happen to be dishing. She's my mom, but you both said she ain't old. But many people just class up to the old.
Strange to be standing up here surrounded by all of you.
Some don't know who I am any better than I know you. And even those of you who have been used to my presence or the sound of my name for years on a daily basis don't understand the first thing about me, just as I can't comprehend the first thing about you. Yet, here we are, sharing this room for what may be the first, last, and only time. Because I've never spoken to some of you, I'm going to tell you a little something about myself. Up until a few days ago, I was afraid of bees my entire life. Those among you who knew me in elementary and middle school will know exactly what I'm referring to. I would sit outside on the asphalt, warming myself in the sun with my little group of friends, and I would hear a faint buzzing. Even if it were 300 feet away, I could hear the bees slowly hovering across the grass towards my unsuspecting back.
I would immediately do one of two things. Jump up screaming and run the other direction, leaving my lunch open as fair game for the sweet-toothed insect. Or I would curl up in a ball with my hands around my head so as to somehow convince the bee that I no longer existed. My friends had the confidence to laugh at me, which I understood and wasn't angry about. I realized how ridiculous I looked, freaking out over something so much smaller than I and much less harmful. And I also realized that secretly, my friends all had that very same insecurity. We would go to class every day, acting a certain way, wearing the same sort of clothes, giving people what they basically expected of us, all because we were afraid to get stung. As long as we existed in the world that had been set for us, all the other kids left us alone. With a few exceptions, of course. There were those rare moments when everyone seemed to coexist. But those moments always vanished just as quickly as they'd come, and we had to go back to being afraid of bees again.
At the time, none of us could really fathom any of the words that I just said. We never would have guessed that in another year we would lose someone because they moved away or because they died. We never looked at our enemies and thought about the possibility of friendship
in high school, and the vast majority of us never expected to change as much as we have, or to experience a good half of the events that have been thrust in our faces, either by life or by our own fault. I used to think, when I was much younger, that high school would be the pinnacle of my career as a person. I thought it was going to be this wonderful fairyland of prom dresses and lavish parties with my own car to drive and a curfew of midnight, which was really late back then. When my gorgeous boyfriend would kiss me goodnight at my front stoop and then stand there for several seconds sighing while I went inside. I never considered fighting with my parents or even rebelling against them, and I honestly believed that I never would. And as the cruel truth became suddenly apparent after my first weeks of being a 15-year-old girl in a tremendous cloud of utter confusion, I held on to the wrong things for support and ended up getting stung several times.
But as I've stepped back over the years and tried to make sense of all the things I never thought I'd do, all the people I never thought I'd meet, all the grades I never thought I'd get, all the stuff I never thought I'd say, and all the opportunities I never thought I'd take or miss, I developed a thankfulness, yes, thankfulness, towards high school.
Because of it, I got used to the little bumps those stings produce, and I learned how to stop running from them. Without high school, I don't think I ever would have known myself in quite the same way, and I never would have known life in quite the same way that I do now, these stings and all. High school taught me how to cope. High school taught me about dealing with people. High school taught me that sometimes it's wiser to keep your mouth shut. Not everyone has to know everything about your life, and not everyone wants to. High school taught me that it's okay to be a dork. You can laugh in front of people, and they might not understand why, but they'll appreciate it anyway.
High school taught me that you can't judge people by one conversation because they could have just been having a bad day. Everyone is weird in their own way. Self-expression is something to be proud of. Grades aren't everything. Yes, you can do what you want in your life. Everyone is a human being. There are just different ways in which to be one. If you leave yourself open, people will connect with you. Love has many faces.
I learned that insight comes from curiosity, and the more knowledge you gain, the more curiosity you have. I learned how to have fun on my own. I learned how to be honest and not feel guilty about it. I learned that my parents love me. And most of all, I learned that each one of you has gone through all of this before, and that everyone after us will have gone through it too. This speech isn't everything I want to say by far. I suppose I wish it was fancier too, but it is how I feel. And the one thing high school never did quite perfect for me is saying how I feel in the way that I want to say it. I wish that each one of us could leave here knowing what's going to happen in the future, or where we're all going to be, and with whom we're going to go there with.
But there is obviously no way to know that. And there is no way to explain or put into words the uneasy excitement that comes with being unsure of where the past is going to fit in when the future begins to come on strong. We've thought ugly thoughts about one another. We've cried in front of each other when we wanted nothing more but to smile.
We've assumed that we are all much stronger than we are. We have helped one another in ways that have gone unrecognized and will continue to go unrecognized. We have spent beautiful moments together inside and outside of chaotic minutes called insanity, and we have let ourselves go. We have held hands, and we have understood each other in moments when we thought that no one else could. The rest of the world has sympathized with us, and to prove that true, I'm going to close with a few lines from my favorite musical, Rent,
to send us on our way. There's only us. There's only this. Forget regrets, or life is yours to miss. No other road, no other way, no day but today. no day but today. Thank you.
The next talented student was voted by his peers as best actor in advanced acting class after his four-year involvement in the drama program at South. He has been a principal performer in the All-State Orchestra, Interlochen High School Orchestra, and the Eugene Youth Symphony.
Next year, he will go to Oberlin to major in music composition and minor in the flute. I present to you Aaron Helgson performing an original arrangement of Amazing Grace.
This evening has been captain of the women's soccer team, a choreographer for the Mr. Axman pageant, and a member of the International High School. She will attend the University of Massachusetts at Amherst. It is a pleasure to introduce senior Rainey Meisel.
Probably not sitting through an eighth period physics class on a beautiful spring day.
It was probably not a senior waiting to hear back from their first choice college, and I guarantee you it was not a freshman eagerly awaiting their license. The first person was probably more likely to be that physics student realizing that the final the next day, or the junior now watching the freshman
parent, proudly watching their senior graduate. As you sit here tonight, watching us, the same question is on every one of your lips. Where did the time go? At exactly what point did Friday nights go from family night to, bye, I'm going out? Remember when the best times of the week were those Saturday night slumber parties or the co-ed birthdays at Skate World? We used to be asleep by 9. Before bed, our favorite thing to do was listen to Daddy's bedtime stories.
School was actually light. After all, grades didn't matter so much, and we got nap times and reading after recess. We played tag and foursquare. Our crushes showed us how they felt by chasing us. It didn't matter how much we sweated, and we didn't have to dress down. We used to dress up for book reports and bring our hamsters to show and tell. Every Friday, we had spelling tests. Our mothers called out the words each Thursday while fixing dinner.
The notes we passed in class always had a box to check or a secret code. We didn't care about winning, calories, or looking bad in a picture. Bad hair days were unheard of. We never worried about getting old too fast. Instead, we wished we could grow up and be like the big kids. And then one day we grew up, and we were the big kids. Our friends changed before our eyes, and there was nothing we could do about it. We learned hard lessons about life and love. School became something important, where we had to prove ourselves on standardized tests and scantrons. Our parents transformed from gods to creatures from another planet, who just didn't understand us or our newfound vocabulary. We stopped playing with our friends and started hanging out. We weren't excited for graduation. We were stoked. College wasn't going to be cool. It was going to be the bomb. Despite communication problems like these, there was one concept everyone seemed to know and understand. The end was near.
Our friends started to take priority, and we struggled to make every moment memorable. We feared losing our friendships, and then we realized that the important ones would last. Plans for after high school began to solidify. Although we were incredibly tired of it, we could now actually answer the questions. So what are you doing next year?
Excitement replaced fear as the countdown reached a close. After 12 years of hard work, it's finally our turn. There were times we thought this day would never come, and there were moments when all we wanted to do was stop time in its tracks. Before we leave, we want to be sure we've lived life to the fullest thus far. We need to know that we've grasped every moment.
But sitting up here, I'm sure we must have done something right, because time only flies when you're having fun, and time has flown.
I said you should prepare to be dazzled. What do you think so far? Behind these incredible students that you've seen stand dozens and dozens and even more that could have come up this evening, had time allowed, and entertained you and wowed you as well. It's an amazing thing to be surrounded every day with legions of people who are smarter and more talented than yourself. Thank goodness for age and wisdom. It's our only remaining edge. We have a special treat for you as the last act prepares to perform. And there are quite a number of them. We have no shortage of talent, musical talent at South, as you must know. And that covers the entire continuum. The artists that you see in front of you play in bands and bands. They seem to pop up with different names and different configurations, but always talented and always entertaining. And the other entertainers tonight had their names read, so fair is fair. The Funk Farm All-Star Coalition tonight consists of Austin Bosinger, Marissa Powell, Ray Mastri, I'll get it, Master Giovanni, what a great name, Bob Nardo, John Wood,
Matt Helgeson, Dave Myrick, Wyatt Southworth, Eric Robinson, Ben Gutierrez Schmick, James Zeller, Sarah DeMoss, Cody Curry, and Ashley Marks, I give you the Funk Farm All-Star Coalition.
Yeah.
is now time for the presentation of the class of 2000. The state of Oregon vests the authority to the Board of Directors of School District 4J to establish the standards and procedures for the graduation from high school. It is with pride, affection, our pleasure to present Sid Renicky and John Hawken, who will read the names of the graduating seniors.
Lindsay Henderson. Jill Schaffner. Bill Hammond. Stephanie Green. Spencer Johnson. David Moats. Isaac Walker Stern. Jesse Hunter. Elizabeth Head. Colette Gordon. Laura Holquist. Tara Booker. Dylan Clausen Kine. Brian Johnson. Jennifer Zettelmeyer. Allison Zarziski. William David Young. Brandon Tate. Tony Cardello. Eli McDougal. Celeste Mansion Ice. Jennifer Shin.
Nicholas Rose. Lynn Marie Roderick. Sean Reinertsen. Michael Monkbold. J.C. Mitchell. Matthew Christopher Miles. Adam Jordan. Jack Alley. Grant Shockley. Blake Steph. Michael Stillern. Schlesinger. Adam Mashofsky. John Carolyn. James White. Arne Zimmer Maza. Micah Ross Newman. Adam James Buckingham. Megan Elizabeth Nelson. Asa Aaron Vickers. Aja Alexander Boise. Luke Sirius. Pete Tripp. Igor Lucas.
Gavin Roberts. Lisa Holden Collins. Mel Best.
Lindsay Kennedy. Dojin Ho. Light Francisco. Jeff Peterson. Matthew Gilstrap. Christopher Dobson. Colin Patrick McDonald. Alexandra Blodgett. Jacob McCulloch Robinson. Anna Schreier. Silas Meredith. Terry Craig. Adam Michael Goldwaite. Kenny Lou Miller. Charlotte Marie Evans.
Alexander Tim. David Zubach. Jason David Mann. Eric Edward Myers. Matthew Saul. Jack Claw. Sean O.G. Cusack. Oliver Johnson. Matthew Thomas Casey. Adam Coverman. Justin West. Eleanor May Fleming.
Kelsey Lyon. Adria Dolan Bynum. Lillian Rose Hogg. Krista Jane Sicello. Brandy Renee Pulliam. Laura Potis. Brittany Paul Larson. Samantha Gary Reeves. Nico Maeda. Ryan Blomberg. Joseph DiMeglio. Helen Lieberman. John Comerlow. Krista Benson. Elizabeth Abbott. Melanie Hindman. Melissa Shankman. Katrina Zico. Adam Brooks.
Cody Simmons. Andrew Tappan. Jacob Falk. Jacob Carter. Bo Bradford. Patrick Sutt. Alicia Ray Lafayette. Sabrina Marie Ohlhauser. Alicia Anderson. Casey Envis. Robin Schumann. Shanti Michael.
Diana Kramer. Kimberly Krista Young. Sarah Barney. Kristen Patricia Rutherford. Stuart Nicholas Deal. Jason Robertson. Brianne Higgins. Scott Patrick Saunders. Daniel John Pointer. Andrew James Jones. David Stephen Wyman. Ari Nathan Saul. Timothy Scott. Jacob Lauer. Brady Morgan. Blake Houseman. John Lenham. Matthew Adam Cooley. Brendan Andrew Lang. Dominic Barbero. Christopher Brian Schneider. Jesse Earl Bradley. Benjamin Bowman. Matthew Vermillion. Catherine Laird. Brian Peterson. Alexander Brega. Ian Morrison. Jenny Rose Bierman. Joshua Zen Ray. Travis Sinth. Reyna Kreska. Holly Bain. Mayla Damian. Nancy Pearson. Travis William Davidson. Jennifer Kibia Cunningham. Elise Marie Fishback. Krista Cunningham. Marja Horner. Elizabeth Barrett. Deborah Ann Forrest. Allison Barbara Stark. Megan Ann Sundahl. Caitlin Marie Potter. Suzanne Nguyen. Brian Akers. Jessica Larson. Aaron Vigo Skelly. Jean Lee. Holly Keegan. Renata D'Antone. Jacob McDonald. Alexa Young Jeffries. Kelly Lee Stout. Emily Claire Short. Matthew Strick.
Elson Allen Petlin. Dorothy Elizabeth Ember Van Allen. Timothy Jane Hayes.
Gabriel Hamill.
Robert King.
Stephen B. Wheeler. Alice Houston Birch. Megan Coleman Hustler. Ellen Yu. Carla Malina Aguilar. Derek Simeon Hart. Philip Cole Barnhart. Nathan Charles Dean Suck. Jayon Hart. Christy Gamble. Rhea Claire Freetile. Chelsea Jasmine Carruthers. Sarah Elizabeth Bloom. Deanna Marie Milliken. Allison Marie Hansen. Emily Wren Burke. Ashley Winslow. Jason Thielen. Samuel Bush. Tyler Downey. Peter Dillon. Rosie Rocha Judd. Melissa Abernathy Logan. Daniel Cutches. Layton Wood. Reed Weaver. Kyle Gibson. Damon Ali Yazzi. Miriam Alida Armendariz Martinez. Justin Myers.
Miles Thompson.
Meredith Ashling Williams.
Raina Patria Boober. Saida Ansarin. Desmond Ford. Sebastian Bolden.
Thank you. morning. I first of all like to present Miriam Armendariz. She's going to present a speech for us before we do the slam.
What they're like, okay, what we learned in high school, like right away, they're like, welcome to Churchill graduation. Here's what we learned. We know that blue and red look better than purple and white. And that was like the only one going, boo, you suck!
Monday night, I was like, I'm not doing this speech. I'm doing it tomorrow's second period. So
fail, so after 676 days, this damn will better be true.
Now you have the senior slams for everybody. You guys, you all filled these out and voted.
Cool, and there's a guy and a girl for each category. Mostly, some of them, there was tags, there were more, but
you'll figure it out. All right, the first one, king/queen of IHS, goes to Helen Yu and Nathan Sutt.
Oliver Johnson and Amanda Schreiber.
Best Smile, Aaron Lebo Skelly and James Zeller.
Best Legs goes to Sean Cusack and Elsie Zarzicki.
Best Hair, RNZM and Alexi Jeffries.
Best Eyes, Renata D'Antone and Michael Skiller.
Best Roots, Asia Vickers.
Best Dancer, Jeff Tunison and Rainey Mizell.
Best Dressed, Jack Alley and Gene Lee.
And Best Laugh, we had a tie for the girls between Beth Wilson and Josie Weldon.
John Wood. Lori Watts.
Best Make and Bake goes to Lori Watts and Jack Alley.
Alright, here we go. Most likely to be president of the United States, Bob Nardo. Hillary Neistat.
Most likely to take over the world is Robert Nardo and his super group.
Most likely to be president of nothing. Bob again.
Most likely to start a huge internet company is Scott Sanders.
Most likely to join a convent/nunnery. Megan Pierce.
Most likely to live in Eugene forever is Sonia Erickson and Eli McDougal.
Most likely to move to Humboldt County. There's a lot of votes in this one. Brady Weeks, Herb, and Travis Olson.
Most likely to be a police officer is Ian Morrison.
Most likely to be a fireman. Jack Law.
Most likely to be Supreme Court Justice is
Helen Yu and Nick Lanowski. Most likely to go to the Olympics, KP, Kate
Blasey. Most likely to go to boot camp because it's a good workout is Dave Hamill and McKenna Morgan.
Most likely to win an Oscar, Adam Goldthwait and Katie McClatchy.
Most likely to win a Grammy is John Wood and Anna Schreier.
Most likely to be a starving artist, Adam Goldthwait. Most likely to attend South parties long after graduation, Eric Myers.
Most likely to invent a new contraceptive, hands down, Amiko Maeda.
Most likely to succeed. We got Nathan Sutton and yours truly, Melissa Barkin.
Yeah! Most likely to flee the country is Ricardo Chavy.
Most likely to go bankrupt from car insurance, Brendan Rosetta, Matt Saul.
Most likely to be a hermit is Aaron Schmitz and Kaylin Kelly.
Most likely to marry his or her car. Bill Barnhart.
Most likely to make more money than the rest of us is Michael Skillard and Blake Stem.
Most likely to be crowned Miss America, Lori Watts.
Most likely to chain herself to a tree is Shaunti Michael.
Most likely to never miss a party, Ted Kemp.
Dog and a white picket fence, Nathan Sutton and Ben Wilson.
Yeah! Okay, most likely to be one of GQ's top 10 most eligible bachelors, Mike Skillard. Yeah!
Most likely to take Craig's place as peer educator is Ben Wilson and Adam Buckingham.
Most likely to win the Nobel Peace Prize, Anna Schreier.
An MTV VJ, Justin West and Lily Ho.
Most likely to be on the front cover of National Enquirer, Zoe Fisher and Brett Olsen.
Most likely to start a revolution, Jacob McDonald.
Most likely to win the Most Likely Awards, Nate Sutton and Justin West.
Cutest couple, Kyla Farrell Smith and Abe Mom.
Cutest freckles, Kelly Cadigan.
John.
The person who had the best party was Shannon Ritchie.
Yeah, Shannon!
So
nice.
Class clown, John Carolyn. Yeah.
And the coolest slacker is James Zeller.
Yeah. The super stud award, Micah Newman.
The person you'd want to be stranded on a desert island with is super stud Micah Newman and Josie Wellman.
Biggest gossip, Ashley Winslow. And biggest trendsetter, Lindsay Kennedy.
Biggest attitude goes to Alicia Sullivan and Adam Buckingham.
Biggest male sweetheart, of course, Max Limebaugh.
And the biggest female sweetheart is Sarah Marshall.
Biggest flirt, Holly Bain and Cole Southworth.
Most changed since freshman year, I think this has changed the most times, is Amanda Shriver and Aja Boise.
Stayed exactly the same since freshman year, Brandon Payne.
Justin West and Suzanne Wynn.
Most individual style, Hillary Neistat and Arne Zimmer.
And the final one, the most intellectual, is Alexis Harrison and Silas Meredith.
Adam Buckingham and Melissa Parkin signing off.